Welcome back, everybody, to another Shave Review. And today we're going to be taking a look at Bar Stern Man's number 42. A little bit of a different scent on this guy. I just kind of went for it when I was looking for something new to try. Label's pretty neat. It's kind of like this old, I don't know if it's supposed to be a dog or just an old man inside like a coat. So top notes are supposed to be petunias, ambergris, tea, and pangalactic gargle blaster. So their little secret scent. I did smell this, and I definitely could smell the tea and the petunias, ambergris. From what I know, it's actually that whale vomit stuff. And it's supposed to resemble like an earthy scent. Which I don't know what full-blown ambergris is supposed to smell like, but I can definitely smell the tea. The tea is very forward, and the petunias are very forward. Kind of like a musky, sweet, maybe a little earthy, but very different scent. It's not bad, but it's different. Something I would definitely see like an older person wearing, even as like a perfume or a cologne. It's got like that classic scent, and that's probably the ambergris I'm smelling. You know, like every old lady has that one specific scent in their perfume when they walk by you and just kills you with scent. I'm getting a hint of that. Yeah, it's not bad, it's just different. Again, I was looking for something different, so got what I was looking for, so we'll give it a shot. I do have the matching splash. Again, pretty cool little label. It's got like that old man or old bulldog, kind of mirrored on both sides. This is the number 42. For the shave today, I'm going to be using the Edwin Jagger 316. Again, I already have a Wilkinson blade loaded up in there, ready to go. I'm currently soaking my with honeycomb, West Coast Shaving honeycomb brush. It's kind of a more compact one. I'm finding like the taller brushes, when I go to lather, it kind of stays like a wet noodle and goes in circles instead of like fanning out. So I'm actually gonna start looking for kind of a shorter, fatter brush. Maybe even dabble into the badger hair, because I haven't actually done badger yet, mainly because of the price and some of the reviews I read. People complain about the smell of animal and it smells horrible, and I'm like, I don't know if I want to go down that road. My synthetics never stink and they're always soft. I don't have to worry about really soaking them. I do anyways, just out of habit. So lather's coming along just nice. Nice pillowing over the sides there. And it is a harder soap. Instead of comparing it to like Taylor of Old Bond Street. It's a classic like harder soap. So nice little lather. I'm just gonna do a decent load on the brush there. Nothing too crazy. Yeah. I'm gonna break out the the old cube, the unscented one that looks a little beat up. So they start to look a little beat up after you use them for a little while. But I do like the cube. I kind of reignited my love for the cube after getting the cloud fruit one. It's just easy to apply. It's there. You're not dealing with any types of canisters. You throw it on. If you put too much on, add a little water. And it makes everything nice and slick. Put this back over here. into it. Okay, weird. On the face, different scents are coming out. There's almost a slight, I want to say maybe aquatic. It's weird. It's like a clean, floral, musky, sweet, possibly aquatic, maybe it's more of like a damp scent. But very nice lather. Get everything nice and coated. I got about 2 days worth of growth here. So nothing crazy to knock down. I usually don't let the facial hair get too out of control. Just because it does become painful sometimes to knock down a lot of hair. it'll actually start to tug. Even if you have a super razor sharp blade, like you're going in with a feather, a fresh feather, it will still tug because there's so much hair there, and it will be painful, which is what I'm always striving to avoid. So I've only got 2 cans of Barrister & Mann. I do like their soap base. I think they do a pretty good job. It always lathers nicely. Also going back to one of my other reviews on the clown fruit, one of the reviewers told me that all of the soaps from Phoenix Artisan and Accoutrements are vegan. And I looked into it. And he was right. And all this time, I was just thinking that they were, had to be tallow based because I had such a negative review on the slickness of vegan based blends. But I tell you what, Phoenix Artisan and Accoutrements nailed it on top of the head because they had me fooled. yeah, excellent soaps. So for this one, after shaving with that one, the layer was a little too thick, so I'm gonna try and thin it out a little bit for the second pass. It's a good scent. It's different. The petunias are nice. It's just when I put this on, I feel like I'm using my grandfather's cologne with maybe a splash of my grandmother's cologne to get that one very specific scent that all super old ladies seem to literally go overboard on that one scent. And I think that's the ambergris. It's kind of a classic old scent, but it's also used to kind of preserve the scents inside of like expensive perfumes. But people have talked about ambergris, and they referred to it as floating gold, because perfumist or people who make perfume will pay a lot of money to get their hands on a chunk of it because it's such a hard product to find because it's literally natural. It comes from a whale. And you have to find it washed up on shore. It's not like you have a tank full of whales that you're harvesting or farming vomit, basically. Yeah, not bad performance. Just don't know what I think about the scent. If you're looking to try something different or you're an older gentleman who wants to kind of have like an old school scent, or like an old school perfume or cologne. Might not be a bad idea to try it, but for me, don't really know how I feel about it. I nick myself a little bit. That's fine. I'll take care of that. Yeah, that's pretty good. So overall, the performance is good. Not too big a fan of the scent. So it's different. It's weird. It's very floral, petunia forward with a strong tea scent, but there's that one very classic old school scent that I just don't see myself wearing every day. To take it out and shave with every once in a while, yeah, of course. You know, no, there's no sense in wasting money or not ever touching it again. It's not bad at all. It's just, it's different. And if I have a bunch of soaps in front of me that are going to smell better and more my age range, I guess you could say, for lack of better terms, I'm going to go with the other ones, of course, to where this one I may even give to like my dad or something, or my grandfather, see if he likes the scent of it. But again, it's not bad. It's just different. Anyway, it's going to get the face washed off and we'll get into the splash here. I don't remember if their splashes are alcohol based. Yep. Denatured alcohol, witch hazel, water, glycerin. Yep, so this one's gonna stink. That's perfectly all right. I've grown to enjoy the sting. It wakes you up in the morning, gets you going. So I'm gonna get the face washed off and we'll get into the splash. Okay. All right. Give it a shake. Whoa. Yeah. Holy cow. Again, it's not bad. It's earthy, musky, florally, with a strong punch of tea. But when I say earthy, musky, I'm referring to that one classic scent that all old people, you know, I'm talking like, you're born like 1930s and before. That one classic scent to where they still have the little squeezy bottle. Yeah. We'll see. A generous little dash here. Oh yeah. So not too terrible of a sting, not compared to Phoenix. This one definitely has more of a witch hazel. That was a very quick burn. It's not bad. Very floral forward. It's okay. Overall experience of the soap was good. I like Barrister Man. I think they have a good soap blend. It shaves nice. Slickness is good. This scent, however, I wouldn't really recommend it unless you like that old school scent that you're chasing the old school scent vibes, or if you're a big fan of the florally teas. Again, it's not bad. I strictly bought it because I thought the label looked cool. And also the scents didn't seem too bad. Along with the teas, I was thinking more of like the Tibetan temple I did a review on. Now granted, this had petunias in it, but ambergris and tea. The only thing I was really missing was like incense to kind of be on par with the other one. But I was totally wrong, but again, it's not terrible. but it's just not a scent profile for me. It's still a great soap, but I would not recommend it based off of the scent. Now, Bar Stern Man's other one they have that's, I think called Aqua. It's great. It's a nice clean scent that's got kind of like the aquatic scent to it. Not quite like, what's it called? Zingari Man's, oh my gosh, having a brain fart. The Watchman. Not like their aquatic scent. Aquatic scent is just this different kind of unique scent. Anyways, it was okay. It was okay. Yeah. Still think the label is pretty cool. Anyways, guys, this was Bar Stern Man's number 42. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please tell me what you do like, what you don't like. I'm always learning from you guys as well with the comments. I do appreciate those. Anyways, until next time, guys, have a nice day.